Hi everyone, I'm Gaten Matarazzo.
And I'm Finn Wolfhard.
David Harbour.
Caleb McLaughlin.
Winona Ryder.
Sadie Singh.
Maya Hawke.
Freya Ferguson.
Joe Kerrion.
And we're from Stranger Things.
With season 4 coming up very soon, we thought it might be helpful if we gave everyone a refresher on what happened in Stranger Things 1, 2, and 3.
Wow, it's crazy. I know.
So, let's rewind all the way back and start with a recap of season 1.
The show follows the stories of a group of friends in a little town of Hawkins, Indiana.
So to start, we've got Will, Mike, Lucas, and Dustin, who are all best friends.
There's also Will's older brother, Jonathan, Mike's older sister, Nancy, and her boyfriend, Steve.
You're an idiot, Steve Harrington.
Anyways, scary government types are in town and doing lots of top secret stuff involving underground monsters and the like, as well as some stuff with a young girl who has telekinesis.
The gang has to team up in season 1 to fight the Demogorgon, a super scary monster that basically has a head made of teeth and comes from an alternate dimension called the Upside Down.
And they have to save Will, who has been kidnapped by the Demogorgon and is being held captive in the Upside Down.
Wrist rocket. You're gonna take out the Demogorgon with a slingshot?
And they have to do this 99% by themselves, because of course, most of the adults in Hawkins, Indiana are less than helpful.
Except for, of course, Will and Jonathan's mom, Joyce, and Sheriff Hopper, who actually later adopts Eleven. Mostly because he's a sweet guy, but also because Eleven was raised by those evil scientists.
Elle, by the way, totally defeats the Demogorgon with her superpowers, and everyone assumes she perishes in the fight, too. But the good news is, Will is back in this dimension and reunited with his friends and family.
All seems normal, except, well, this is Hawkins, and it won't stay normal for long.
Season 2 brings a new batch of friends to Hawkins, like Max and Billy, a sibling duo who moved all the way from California.
This is also the season where we meet Lucas's smart mouth younger sister, Erica. She's super cute, hilarious.
Everyone needs an Erica.
But it also brings some unpleasant new characters, like the Mind Flayer, who, if you couldn't guess from the name, is not a hero in this show.
It enslaves races of other dimensions by taking over their brains using its highly developed psionic powers.
So obviously, with creatures like that in town, this year doesn't go much better than the last.
It turns out Elle survived, and Hopper has been keeping her safe in his cabin. They eat some awesome waffles together.
She's antsy in isolation, wants to see her friends, or like, anyone.
Eventually, she runs away and meets up with some other kids who also have superpowers.
Watch it, kid.
Mouth breather.
Friendships are tested, relationships are born, Elle gets a makeover,
and closes an interdimensional gate.
Will gets possessed, and Joyce's new boyfriend gets eaten by Demodogs.
Did you mention a gate closing?
Yeah.
All the sci-fi monster stuff is over, right?
Yeah.
On to season 3. The big thing happening in Hawkins this year is the opening of the new Star Court Mall. Remember, it's 1985. Malls weren't weird abandoned mega buildings back then. They were weird thriving mega buildings.
And with the evil monsters of the past seasons vanquished, all the kids can finally relax and start living a normal American teen lifestyle. You know, shopping, ice cream, dating, more makeovers, just general non-monstery stuff.
Except for, of course, Will, who still has tons of PTSD from the whole being held captive in an evil dimension and then possessed by a monster thing.
Hey, you okay?
We should also cover their relationships in season 3 because there are a lot of them.
Mike is dating Elle and they keep kissing with the door closed.
Hey!
Lucas is dating Max sometimes. It's kind of your typical on-again, off-again romance. Jonathan is dating Nancy, and Dustin is dating his mystery camp girlfriend, Susie.
Oh, and Steve wants to be dating his new coworker, Robin, but that probably won't work out for him.
Steve.
Also, a lot of crew have jobs now, like real jobs.
Jonathan and Nancy are working at the local Hawkins newspaper.
Billy is lifeguarding at the pool.
And Steven and Robin are working at Star Court Mall's Ice Cream Scoops Ahoy, where Erica is their number one customer.
So remember before how we said that all the sci-fi monster stuff was over? Well, folks, that was a lie. We lied to you. The Soviets have come to town and are attempting to open a portal to the Upside Down.
Which, if you watched the previous two seasons, you know is a bad idea, like the worst.
And with that, the Mind Flayer is back. Not only is he back, but he's enslaving Billy to do his bidding.
And there's also a whole thing with rats. Just bad news all around.
Jonathan!
I have a lead.
But Hawkins is a town full of outright badasses, and our crew of heroes sets off to uncover what the Russians are up to beneath the mall.
And for good measure, Sheriff Hopper and Joyce set off to do the same, because Joyce has been freaking out about her fridge magnets. True story.
A magnet? Magnets? And then they... Where we kidnap
Joyce,
you.
Joyce, please!
Now, this leads, of course, to a series of misadventures. But we get to meet Alexei, the friendly Soviet scientist who just wants to have a Slurpee and be friends, especially with Murray. Hi, Alexei.
We, however, do not love Grigori, the ruthless assassin sent to kill Alexei for his defection. Boo to Grigori.
Tomatoes! We'll throw them. It's like an old Shakespeare jest.
Tomatoes.
So at this point, things are looking very grim for our Hawkins heroes. The Red Army forces are hunting them from high and low.
The Mind Flayer is getting stronger and more relentless, and Billy is totally possessed.
Up at Hopper's cabin, the Mind Flayer finally comes for Elle, seeking revenge because she closed the gates to the Upside Down.
To make matters worse, over at the local fairgrounds, Grigori tracks down Alexei, who is with Hopper, Joyce, and Murray, shoots him dead.
They got Alexei, Jim!
Since it's the 80s, all this converges on the local mall. First, the kids break into the underground Russian base.
Let's be honest, that's pretty brave. Then the adults break into the very same underground Russian base using a bit of cunning trickery, which includes a very memorable rendition of the theme of the Neverending Story.
Reach the stars, fly a fantasy.
Meanwhile, the kids take cover in the mall to hide from the Mind Flayer and its disciple, Billy.
And even more bad news, the fight at the cabin left Elle without her powers, so things are shaping up to be a little one-sided for this fight.
So the Mind Flayer, which is a super terrifying monster from another dimension, definitely has the upper hand. The gang is able to keep it distracted thanks to a genius idea from Lucas, throwing fireworks at it while Elle helps Billy to break the control the monster has over him.
Play this, you ugly piece of shit!
Billy, who's been a mega jerk since the moment we met him, fully redeemed himself by sacrificing himself to the Mind Flayer, saving Max and her friends. What a complex character.
Deep below the food court, Hopper and Joyce place a bomb on the Russians' Upside Down opening machine.
But Grigori shows up, and while Hopper is able to defeat him, he is left trapped with the bomb. When it detonates, it appears Hopper gets blown up too.
Poor Hopper.
The good news is that the bomb closed the gates of the Upside Down, causing the Mind Flayer to keel over dead, saving everyone else.
The government, the US one, not the Soviet one, swoops in to destroy them all and sweep all this nasty interdimensional business under the rug.
Elle and Byers pack up their house, deciding to move to another town that isn't Hawkins.
Can you blame them?
No.
A monster attacks the town once a year. I'd be packing a suitcase too.
Absolutely, I would have left season one.
Yeah.
But don't worry, Mike and Elle finally confess that they love each other and make plans to reunite.
In the final shots, we see a remote prison somewhere in Russia, with guards discussing an American prisoner.
So like maybe, just maybe, there is some hope for Hop.
Yeah, he's definitely a Soviet prisoner.
Don't worry, he survived and he'll be back in season 4.
Hopefully this little recap has gotten you all excited to watch the new episodes.
Volume 1 of Stranger Things 4 premieres May 27th and Volume 2 comes out July 1st.